So it's not as bad. I still have shortness. It's not as short. It's like 90%. You know, I still feel something there. Like this morning, I was trying to. It was breaking up a little bit. It's always worse right before I go to bed, and in the morning. That's when I feel the worst. During the day, it's okay. So it's just completely freaking me because it's been so long since I've had any type of symptom like that. And I really did psych myself out. It could have been completely a detox effect. And I just was so consumed in my head with that mold that I found in the basement. And on top of that, the mold that we found upstairs. And I mean, it was just like double whammy. Mold mildew nightmare. We're gonna call this the mold mildew nightmare of 2018. We're still gonna have a lot of fun because now I'm thinking about other things that excite me, like working out, the road. We're going on the road, so it would be not a juice fast on the road, but living raw on the road. Living raw on the road with Blue October. Longwave. Longwave has got to be one of my favorite bands on the planet.
I am everything you wanted. I am everything you need. But I can feel it again.
I was a fan before I got to work with them. So maybe that was Law of Attraction as well. That song Tidal Wave, amazing. But that entire album, The Strangest Things, that album was on loop while I was working out. I don't know what it was. This is like before I ever worked with them. I would listen to them like daily. And I don't know, there was something about the words and the way the music was. I don't know what it was, but I just like instantly, you know how like some people like need the heavy rock, like Metallica or something like that? Not me, man. Longwave made me ride a wave long. Because I was like, okay, that's my favorite band in the past. I literally, there was a moment in 2002. In 2002, because I was really getting physically right. I was doing Atkins. 2002, I was doing Atkins hardcore. I was losing so much weight on the carnivore diet. I was like full-blown carnivore. And more, and I was working out every day. I was getting ripped diesel. I got down at the time in 2002 in my heaviest. When I started Atkins, I was like 290. I haven't hit the 300s yet. I was like 290. And I got down to 240. I lost 50 pounds. And I was working out like crazy. So I looked pretty good for my wedding. My wedding... Physically, I was the strongest I ever was. Did I do the carnivore diet right? No. I mean, it wasn't lean meat. It was just disgusting. Wings. I was eating like chicken wings and cheese and the worst. Oh my goodness gracious. I'm talking about hardcore Atkins. I was, oh man, I was making these cream pies. I did the whole thing, man. Everything Atkins was promoting, I was on board. I thought it was like the miracle diet of all miracle diets. I was just in, wow. Now that I'm thinking about it, how crazy was that? I probably lost like 10 years of my life. That just, but I felt so good, to be honest. It was crazy. Right there and then, I guess that was my first introduction on how bad grains are for you, really. You know, the glues. Because there was no more bread in my life, and here I am, like, transforming. Pretty nuts. My first introduction into really trying to do something for myself. Yeah. Wow. And it took years and years. I was, like, completely blindfolded after that. Because then I got hurt. After my wedding, I got hurt. And working out, and I gained some weight back, so now I'm like on a slow incline again, like I've been for years. And then boom, I was playing softball. I was very athletic. I was playing softball, and I was on a useless game. We're already in the playoffs. It didn't mean nothing. Here I am stretching a hit to third base, and I'm running to third, and I take this dive bomb slide, like if I was going to slide across the whole entire field. And instead of sliding, my cleat gets stuck, and I completely break my leg in half. I broke my fibula and my ankle, and I have screws in my leg and everything. It's just horrible. And it's funny because I think I mentioned in a video a little, like a few weeks ago, saying that I had my, and it was during the fast, I haven't felt this much pain in that region in a while, and I got really nervous that like the fast was like going into that and starting to like push the metal out and say, hey, you're not supposed to be here kind of thing. Because it is, I have metal in my leg. I have a plate and screws and everything else. It's still in there. They said, you know, normally people don't take it out because it doesn't bother them, and you could leave it in there and your bone kind of grows around it. It's like, and if you do have to take it out where there's, you know, there's something wrong, it's a real serious surgery because, again, they got to chip the bone and everything, and you have, you know, the infection and whatever. It's freaking surgery, no matter how you look at it. They got to put you out, and they got to cut your leg in half. So I got really nervous about that I had that pain there. But thank God it subsided. And my leg used to be much bigger than my other leg. And I always, you know, it was the surgery. There was no pain. I was able to walk and I was able to run and everything. Like he you know, I guess the doctor did his job. But there was always that little size difference. And I noticed that the size difference is much less than it used to be. And I guess that's with all my diet now. After I broke my leg, that was it. Whoop! I hit the 300 mark. Whoop! Then I bought the bar. Whoop, you know, but in 2010 when I bought the bar, so I had those 8 years of 240 to 320, you know, so I gained 80 pounds in those 8 years, yeah, you know, with no worries. Like those 8 years, like when my son was born, my daughter was born, I just did not care about nothing, you know. I still watch, believe it or not, I was always watching, which is, it sounds ridiculous, but I feel like if I really wanted to, I could have been bad. Bad, like 400, 500 pound bad. because I still watched. As heavy as I got, I was still on top of what I was intaking. Like, I wouldn't sit down with a box of cookies. Like, I'd rather have a half a hero. You know what I'm saying? Like, there were certain things that I just knew were just ridiculous. You know, I was already heavy. What? Why would I do that? You know?
Planter's pot. Oh, it's very heavy and huge. I'm going to put a tree in here. Oh, I've been starting to bring plants in the house, and I kind of really love, like, watering them and watching them thrive, and it's good for the air in the house, you know? They are natural detoxifiers, you know? They're cleaning up the air constantly, so the more plants, the better. I have a plant next to my bed now, and that's breathing into me. I really enjoy it. You know, maybe spring. Maybe this year, finally. Oh, hello. Dude, dirty boy. See, I live by a park, you know, so outside I have a lot of milfy milfs walking by with their babies heading to the park, and some of them are just like, I'm working out, I got my baby, and I'm working out. Yeah! Hello, I'm Bobby Buds at Milford City. Do you need a coaching? You need a health coach? Hell. Speaking of what I'm talking about right now, fapping. NOFAP. Have you heard of this? I'd like to tell you today that I'm going to do a month. I'm just going to just sprinkle that out there. I don't know. I'm still gonna enjoy time with the wife, but I'm not going to complete. 30 days. See where it takes me. I heard it's better meditation. I heard there's so many benefits. So many benefits. And it really does bring this raw food city into a whole nother level of the matrix, you know? So we just keep growing here on this channel. We keep growing. So I'm gonna give myself another challenge. Okay? Another challenge. This is Craig Lloydgren, married and miserable. Today's his birthday. Happy birthday. I had to wear your shirt today. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I hear Bobby. Bobby must be home. He's probably gonna watch this video and go, what the F's a fap?
Hello, Bob.
Hello.
Daddy's on camera.
I passed.
You passed?
Math test.
You passed the math test. Very good, very good. Very good. But are you sure you don't want to be homeschooled in Hawaii in a cabin?
No.
No? Pooping outside?
No.
Walking barefoot?
Sorry, no.
Dreams. Dreams. I could dream, you know, a man could dream. Okay, I'm putting it out there. Law of attraction. You heard me? Barefoot? Barefoot in Hawaii, please? Okay. So, yeah, you can definitely see the color. I'm better. I'm much better. It's like 90%. Maybe if I just gorilla myself. I heard that's good for you, too. Hear that? You hear the bubbling? That's definitely the lymph system, right? The lymph. Limp moving around in there. Alright, can't wait to work out. Can't wait to go on tour. Can't wait to keep pounding videos. More thrilling days. Living in the raw food city. Yeah.
I get a real kick out of sitting in playgrounds and watching everybody play. But not saying a word, just staring. It's wonderful.
How nice is that?